You might be asking yourself, is this even Minecraft? How can terrain generate like this? And I'm here to tell you that it totally can. It's crazy to look at this and realize that, yeah, this is Minecraft all the way through. Like, there is a village right over there. This is a mod that's called TerraMath, and it uses mathematic equations on Java Edition to generate terrains just like this one. And the terrain generated on your screen is something that I randomized. I didn't even have to make an equation. It's just something that it made up for me. Now, that's not always going to be the case. As you saw with the first terrain, I actually got it from the TerraMath website, where they have a bunch of default equations. I'm going to go over all these example equations and general tips so you can generate terrain mathematically. As you see here, I have all my worlds, but if you want to make a new world or use the terrain generator, you need to click create new world. You have to use the default world type. It has to, because you want to access the terrain settings. And this is where you can randomize your math function. As you see, there's so much different things that it's randomizing at this current moment. Let's just say we're going to go with this, right? Now, scale. I would recommend turning scale a little down, maybe to like 3, but the default is 5. So I'm gonna generate a world just with this random seed. And as you see, the world is entirely flat. Just sometimes you will get unlucky with world generation, and it does happen, especially if you randomize. Off camera, this was something else that I randomized. I got a little bit luckier. You know, obviously there's a lot of visual complexity to this with the noise in the mountain, but it took me about 5 to 6 tries to get something like this. So the randomize function is a little interesting. Sometimes you'll get good stuff, sometimes you won't, but when you do, it's actually pretty interesting. We have our first example, and by the way, all examples will be in the description down below, but this is the basic wavy landscape, which is just a sine function. And if you know anything about sine functions, go up and down, up and down, up and down. Something to kind of note about this is a lot of the landmarks are actually spawning on top. I think there was an ocean monument, which is actually right there. Something that's really interesting with a lot of the terrain generation, I guess compact it is. Again, this is as basic as you can get with the sine function, or just like the mathematical functions. I don't even think the preview did it justice. I actually really like this. I think this looks really cool. And if you want to start out with something, this is just something to start out with. The next two are kind of similar, and I'm going to kind of lump them in together, but we have the spiky volcano-like terrain and the rolling mountains. Now, just like the sine function, this is very repetitive. This type of terrain is a little bit more varied than the simple sine function, like the wavy terrain. And I also scaled it down because I don't know how much I liked the bigger terrain. You have to generate a lot more of it. And I'm sure if you add some noise to it or just something a little bit extra, because you can definitely play around with these type of equations, you could probably get something pretty interesting. Now, this is very repetitive too, but instead of it being in a straight line, it's kind of in this checkered pattern where you have these mountains. They're basically everywhere, but every single place is a mountain. Some of the structures, they spawn on top. You have a ruined nether portal over there. And this is as basic as you can get with these mountain structures. You can definitely make it so the mountains maybe appear a little bit less, but as a starter function, or if this is somehow how you would want to play your world, I think this is a fine option. Getting into the next piece of terrain, you have the terrace landscape plateau, which starts showing its capabilities, or at least the mod's capabilities, of generating some amazing terrain. So I don't think the equation is really that complex. It just kind of utilizes, again, two different equations where it kind of creates this checkered pattern. Solution that this terrain creates are weird circular like terrain buildup, and you can get something absolutely beautiful just like this. One of the reasons I just love this one in particular is just kind of how, again, the terrain and the structures kind of generate around it. Like over there, you see the villages kind of scattered across like all the levels of terrain. And then you have kind of like a little water pool in the middle there. And then you kind of have all the dripstone over there. I think the way that the caves and the terrain interact together are really cool. And then also you have kind of like the shifting levels of, if you look really closely at the sand, it's almost like it's sloped per se, right? And forests just look amazing. So many things just look absolutely phenomenal. If you could check out this mod just for this equation, I would strongly recommend it, because this is just probably what inspired me to even want to do this video. And the last example we have is the crater filled terrain. Now, this is kind of like almost like a flatlands per se, right? We have a lot of mobs just kind of walking around. It's really funny because I think there's drown spawners, but the drowns can't really spawn. So they're just kind of dying in the sunlight, which is actually really funny. But essentially, this is just a better textured version of like a super flat world, which is actually really interesting if you wanted to like make a super flat world, but you're like, I kind of don't like that there's no terrain generation, or I kind of want to play like a general world, this would be kind of like what you would do. This is, again, not very varied, not a lot of levels. I think this is supposed to be like an ice spikes biome, but as you see, the ice spikes don't really want to spawn, and if they spawn, they're pretty miniature. The spruce trees also look a little funky as well, like some of them are pretty tall, and then some of them are, of course, like really short. And again, I think that this is an incredible example, and if you want something that is visually stunning and something where you can find a new way to explore or play Minecraft, I would strongly recommend something like this. If you have any equations that you find that you are like, dang, this is really cool and I would like to share it, definitely put in the comments down below. I might make a new video just based on what you guys find, and hopefully you download the mod pack and give it a try, because honestly, this is just absolutely stunning. So many just cool things you can do with this, and hopefully you find it somewhat exciting.